Hi friends, happy Wednesday, welcome back to Magic Knight Rayearth. I think it's time to catch up on our diary entries. You don't have to save before reviewing the trip memories, I just like to, out of habit, in case something happens with the save state. Alright, so we read number 8, so one more entry.
We did it! The monster in the cave is ancient history! Even though we destroyed the giant spider, we gave the credit to Lucchino because he's the one the people have trusted to protect the village. Now that the people feel safe, things are returning to normal in Palizu.
This wizard named Lucchino made all sorts of trouble for us when we tried to destroy the monster in the cave. But we did manage to find and defeat the monster anyway. The goofy part is that Hikaru gave all the credit for defeating the monster to Lucchino. I can't figure her out sometimes.
Though we encountered many obstacles in the cave, we managed to overcome the monster. Once we returned to the village, Hikaru gave all the credit to this old wizard named Lucchino. My respect for her is growing as this adventure continues.
I'd like to see an entry where everyone's nice to each other. Hi, Kla. What you got for us? Your next task should be to gather information at the village by the sea. Well, I suppose we could just walk up to people and start asking questions. That's been the plan so far. As well as examining every single object inside a gross abandoned house. Did you gain any information that will aid in your pursuit of evil? There is an evil beast residing at the bottom of the sea, but it's quite a long way down. Even though you don't know the precise whereabouts of this creature, you should search the water thoroughly. Sounds like a plan. Boo, search the water thoroughly. Oh geez, that was a long jump. Wonder why that happened. Huh. Have I talked to you? Ah yes. The obligatory, this is the name of this town, NPC. Come on, I want to see what everyone else thinks about the fortune teller. Or not? Well, 1 out of 3 people think it's a good idea. Wuzuzu! When you lose your way, I can show you the way. Moonbook. Wazaza. There is one who can help you on your journey. You must seek that one out. Wuzuzu. Alright, so the Moonbook is just telling us what we already know, basically. I expect if I paid the 20 gems for the sun fortune, it would tell me exactly where I need to go, what I need to do to find this person. Ooh, new item shop. Aww. Just the same old crap. I hope that's not all I can spend my money on. I like to think that I'm building up to something interesting. The pharmacy is now open for business. Please come inside. I wonder if they have any homeopathic remedies here. Aw, foo. I expect better of you. Why would I buy health and magic from you? I have health and magic at home. Right here. I guess that's not portable. I should just buy some empty bottles and bottle some water from that fountain. Aww. Rawr. It's cute. The townspeople are jerks. Everyone complains about my little Jiminy, but he's such a good, quiet pet. Why can't they just accept him for the way he is? His name is Jiminy? Look at him. He's absolutely adorable. That's right. What? Well, thanks. This is the first time anyone's ever said a nice thing about him. So, the mirror is big. That's what I'm gathering from that. Ooh, accessory case. I wouldn't mind owning some of this stuff. All right. No clues in the sink. I will have to search elsewhere. I've heard about that. Golly. I think Sarah is a girl with the pet monster, if I remember correctly. Ma'am, I assure you that Princess Emerald is totally fine. It's my job as Magic Knights to prevent the people from panicking. Not finding much in the way of clues. Let's talk to the monster girl again. Or the girl with the monster. Aww. That's awesome. All in the line of duty for the Magic Knights. Rawr. Let's go around talking to everyone again. Normally how these games work. So I'm expecting to get some sort of water traversal item, at which point maybe I can backtrack to Palizu Village and maybe get that health gem. Oh, I haven't been in here. Hey! That's just straight up a lie. Hello. Sorry for barging into your bedroom. Do you have any clues? People are so judgmental. Well, we're just going to have to go back and be extra friendly to Sarah now. Now that we know what jerks all these people are. Oh, maybe not. Not yet. I mean, I guess I could spend my gems on the sun book, since I don't have anything better to spend it on. I don't know, I feel like I can... Oh! This is a direction. This section of the wall sounds different when I bang against it. Kind of hollow. Okay. Well, I can't use my weapons here. I can't cast magic. Is it telling me that I need to, like, get a running start and run into them? No? That didn't do anything. Well, I'm glad I know I can go that way now. This whole area just looked like a big wall. Is that a direction? No. Swim to the island. Yeah, because you're evil. Can I go in here? Yeah, this is the abandoned... Oh, wait. Okay. I'm starting to piece it together. The grumpy guy in the previous town is a swimming teacher, and I need to learn how to swim. Yeah, going into the gross abandoned house reminded me of that guy. Because I'm like, he should live here. Then he'll have something to complain about. Yeah, he mentioned being a swimming teacher. Of course, I don't know why he's going to be more amenable to our requests now. We didn't do anything, except maybe now we have the plot trigger. You're asking me to teach you how to swim? Just leave me alone. I've already given up teaching others my technique. Why did you quit being a fisherman and move to this village? Oh, it's the same guy. Okay. What makes you think I'm going to tell you that? It's not your business, is it? We must cross the sea to get to the island of ice, and you're our only hope. Ellipsis. 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 You don't want my help. I'm no good for anyone anymore. I can't even save a lousy animal. When a little girl's pet fell into the ocean and got caught up in the strong currents, I dove into the water, confident that I could save it, but I was moments too late. The little girl went back empty-handed. I'll never forget her tear-filled eyes. I've always bragged, but I really don't swim that well. I'm a useless failure. I've lost all confidence in my ability. Just leave me. Wait, the little girl you're talking about, is her name Sarah? How did you know? I can't believe this. You are so pathetic, Kaltus. What did you say? Who are you to persecute me? Sarah's already overcome her sorrow. Despite the villagers treating her like an outcast, she still moved on with her life. But you're too busy wallowing in self-pity to get up and on with yours. Come on, guys, let's get out of here. Huh? But he's too busy sulking over his sorry butt. It's no use. You have no idea how irritated this makes me. No, I think I got a pretty clear picture. But now, what are we supposed to do? If we don't get him to give us that swimming lesson, the island will remain out of our reach. Well, we'll find a way. We just have to think. Unfortunately, I don't think there is another solution. Alright, Umi. Put on your apologizing face. Oh. Is there like a how to swim book around here anywhere? We were watching that door the entire time, and there's no other way out of this place. Well, maybe he crawled through the window somehow. Alright, where'd you go? Come back. Make amends. Nah, that's just a shop. Can the elder offer us any advice? Nope. Well, maybe Lukino. Alright, well, maybe now I have to head back to Taplon? If Clef has any advice. Nah, that's old info. Alright, well let's head back to Taplon. Maybe that guy made his way back there to apologize to Sarah or something. I don't have any control over this world map, by the way, in case you were wondering. It just sort of auto-moves you from one location to the next. Have you seen a grumpy swimming teacher? Did you move back into your old crappy home? No? I mean, honestly, it's not that bad. You could spend like 15 minutes cleaning up that place and it would be fine. I talk to you? Kaltus. Don't know why I can't remember that name. Kaltus. Or maybe Kaltus. Well, he has a portrait, so maybe we'll hear some actual dialogue with him. Yeah, that should have been my hint. Kaltus left the village, and there's only so many other places that I could go. Ah! Oh, look. Shh. Sarah, have you been alright? Well, sometimes I get sad, but Jiminy always helps me through it. Jiminy? You mean this monster? Don't you dare call him that. Jiminy is Jiminy. I found Jiminy lying on the beach, almost lifeless, so I took him home with me. He's as gentle as a kitten. He'd never do anything to hurt anybody. I'm so sorry, Sarah. Oh no, Kaltus, I'm the one who should be apologizing. Hmm? When Sildra was drowning, you did your best to help. I'm truly grateful for that. It's just, Well, I was both upset and angry at the time, and I'm sorry I hit you. I've been wanting to say that for a long time. It wasn't until everyone started treating me badly that I realized how selfish I was. I'm sorry, Kaltus, and thank you. Sarah, it's okay. Besides, now I have Jiminy, so I don't feel lonely anymore. You really are quite special, Sarah. We weren't eavesdropping. Hey, you. Hello. What a surprise. I've decided to teach you. Let's go before I change my mind. Come again? Alright, everyone pay attention. You're about to learn how to swim. This Kaltus might turn out to be useful. I thought that little break in the wall looked suspicious. Wait! What are you doing? I can't swim! Oh my. Alright, pay attention. This is how it's done. Secret skill, Roaring Rapid Wave Cut. Ooh, what a beefcake. I can do that. I still don't understand. This isn't going to work. Help! In that case, here. Aww. Oh, thank you. That's much more to my liking. I'm floating with no effort. Perfect. Let's move. We've got a cave to explore.
Precious! Mysterious Sephiroth Lecture number 2! Hikaru and the others have mastered the skill known as Roaring Rapid Wave Cut.
Yes, in other words, the girls have learned how to swim like beavers.
Now they can journey to the ice cave on the island to the north.
By pressing the attack button while in the water, the girls swim forward. It's that easy.
Okay, that's it for now. We hope you're enjoying the game.
See you later, kids.
I am enjoying the game. Oh, I have to mash the button. So all we had to do was buy 3 life preservers? That would have been way easier. Well, you accelerate as you mash, so it's not that bad. Well, obviously the first thing I need to do is go back and get that heart container and then see what's past the water to the east in Polizu Village. It looks like it leads to another town, maybe. I think you can look at the world map by pressing one of the buttons that doesn't do anything, like X or Y, or one of the buttons I haven't used yet. I just press the Y button. Oh, is this like an actual fast travel thing? Oh, it is. I didn't realize that's what it would be. Okay. So we can go back and see if there's any news at Precious Manor. I mean, probably not, since I haven't found any more Escudo. But you never know. Precia, you just appeared to me in a vision. You and Clef. You said something about an attack button? I was hoping you could explain it to me. I need more explanations. Could you go over again in detail how I swim in water? Alright, press Y again. I was like, that's a pretty significant load just to look at the map. But if it's an actual fast travel thing, then that's not too bad. So, now that it's not moving automatically, I actually get a better look at the map here. So, it looks like there's a big crater with probably nothing in it. Another big crater. Someone built steps to some sort of, that would be the pool that we jumped in the first time we got Escudo, I think. And then there's Precious Manor over to the west, and some rough-looking mountains, and maybe another little town over to the east. I'm probably not supposed to go there yet, but let's at least see what happens if I try to. Yeah, I thought the world map was all automatic. I'm glad I remembered to try that. Alright, see what's over here first. Okay, I can go south. And there's some rocks. Keep going west. East, rather. Rainbow Junction Shop. Here we go. Finally, I can find out what I've been saving all these gems for. Oh, and this music rules. Oh, this place rules. Heck yeah. Oh my god, this music is so good. I want to turn it up so you can listen to the music. Oh, I love this place. I want to live here too. There are a lot of locations in this game that I would want to live in. Howdy, I'm the Rainbow Elder. Collect the rainbow amulets and I will grant you many wonderful and magical items. Please select the item that catches your fancy from the counter, and I'll tell you the cost. Oh, so the rainbow amulets are actually a kind of currency. Like it's not just collecting or stuff at the end. I forgot about this part. Precious shameful secret. This is a very embarrassing photo of Precia. If you want this, you need one amulet of each color. Ah yes, the poo-poo shoes. Naturally, the poo-poo shoes make a cheerful sound. Two! Yeah. Oh, that sounds useful. Three! That's weird. Just Auto gives you that text when you walk in front of him. It's very strange. Magic recovery ring. With it, your magic points slowly increase as you stand still. Wait a second. So five of each color. Three amulets of each color. So it's not possible to get all of the items? Because the... Like, these two items right here would be all of the amulets. Because there's only 8 of each color, right? This is the Black Diary. I have no idea who wrote it, and I don't want to know. You actually want this? You girls are weird. If you want this, you need 7 amulets of each color. Okay. I mean, unless it doesn't actually consume your amulets when you buy the stuff. In which case, it's not really a shop. Alright, well, that was exciting. Hopefully I'll be able to get some of that stuff at some point. Whispering Woods? Wait. What is this? Okay. Well, tune in tomorrow and we'll see what's going on in the Whispering Woods. Take care, everyone. Goodbye.